When K-pop fans buy albums, there's one thing we're most excited about: the photo card. There's just something so thrilling about getting your bias on your first pull. Pero di ba sobrang fulfilling rin kapag nakolekta mo na lahat ng photo cards ng mga faves mo? Annyeong K-munity! It's Gab! I've been collecting photo cards for less than a year, and I wanted to share with you guys how I organize and keep my photo cards protected by using a binder. If you've always wanted to start your own photo card collection, pero di ka pa sure where to begin, or if you've been looking for ways to put your PCs on display na hindi lang lagi sa phone case mo, you've come to the right place. Let's start with the materials. D-ring binder, pocket sleeves, dividers, card sleeves, and your photo cards.
Be careful, Joseon.
I started collecting photo cards because I never pulled my bias. And at that time, I'd watch binder flip-throughs on YouTube, and they made me want certain cards. So I went on Shopee to buy replica cards just to get over this feeling, but it backfired and it made me want to collect the real things more. And since I'm a big nerd, I started researching on the best binders, best pocket sleeves. I started even measuring my photo cards just to see if they'd fit certain pocket sleeves and card sleeves I've found online. Once you've pulled your photo card from the album, you're presented with these three common options. Some put it back inside the photo book of the album. Brave ones put it at the back of their phone cases. Those who are attached to them either display them using top loaders and acrylic frames or compile them in a binder. I personally use a 1.5-inch D-ring binder. I really like it because the front, back, and spine have transparent plastic over it, so you can insert your collages, put stickers over it, and make it totally your own. It has an inner pocket for loose papers. I use it sometimes as a background when I take photos of my cards and items that I don't have sleeves for yet. And I think the best part about it is this straight edge over here that's not present in another common type, which is the O-ring, because it aligns your pocket sleeves so the sides are neat. I used to have an O-ring binder or a round ring binder, but eventually I switched it out to my current one because the sides were always so messy. There's so many types of binders out there, especially for professional card collectors. There are no-ring ones with built-in sleeves already that are meant to store super expensive cards. I put my cards inside a binder because I like collecting in sets. I think this is a big determining factor if you're choosing between binders and top loaders. Binders allow you to fill up pages with similar themes, whereas top loaders are best for storing your favorite cards because they're protected and can be displayed wherever. A lot of the fun in collecting photo cards for me comes from seeing which concepts blend well together per page. K-pop albums are ingenious and come with the most creative inclusions. That's why it's understandable to get overwhelmed thinking about which pocket sleeves would fit which cards. Here are the common types. 9P or 9 pocket is the most common one because it fits standard album photo cards well. 8P is for slightly larger cards, usually tour photo cards. 4P is best for smaller 3x5 postcards. 3MP is for 4x6 photos and postcards. 3P horizontal is for bookmark types. 2P is for bigger postcards, usually 5x7. 1P is for mini posters. And there's another kind, 20P. These were made ideally for coin collectors, but they fit ID photo cards as well. There's just two main brands you have to choose from when looking to buy these pocket sleeves: Ultra Pro and BCW. It's on a case-to-case basis of which brand you should go for. There's just a super small difference in the dimensions that make a big difference, especially with the type of card you're trying to store. Personally, I go for Ultra Pro Platinum line just because Silver line is a bit flimsier. For everything except for 4P, because BCW's 4P is slightly wider. Aside from that, these two brands are made to give you wiggle room to arrange as you please while ensuring your cards are safe. For extra protection though, I highly recommend double sleeving. You could even say that this is my favorite part of every unboxing. For now, I only double sleeve standard album-sized photo cards. I use two sizes of card sleeves: 56x87mm from Sleeve Kings and 63.5x88mm from Mayday Games Premium. Just like the pocket sleeves, these are also acid-free and have no PVC. But Gav, why do they have to be acid-free and no PVC? Because these are paper materials. Paper has natural acidity to it, which makes yellowing inevitable. These sleeves help slow that down and protect it from everyday elements like dust. Personally, the brands really don't matter as long as the dimensions, component, acid-free, non-PVC, and microns, just a fancy way of saying thickness, honestly, are good. I'm okay with it. This is an important tip when you're double sleeving. I sleeve them downside first for the inner, then upside first for the outer. That way, when I slide them inside the pocket, the card isn't exposed. So that's the basics of protecting and having a vessel for your cards. Now here's the fun part. Setting the theme for your binder. You could just collect your bias line, your oath biases from different groups, or whatever. The possibilities are endless. For me, I found that my eyes wanted my bias in the middle with two other members on each side from the same album to form a trio. For concepts I couldn't really do this for example, for oddly shaped photo cards that won't align with my whole trio agenda, or full sets that come with an album, I decided to organize my binder according to that. Korean albums, whole member sets, DVD inclusions, etc. I even dedicate a section of my binder for fan art prints and stickers, notes from sellers and friends, cute freebies, and some hang tags from wearable merch. I think this is my favorite part. It's when I'd browse through my binder and couldn't pinpoint where each section ended and the next one started that I had the idea to make my own binder dividers. They're simply there to mark sections of my binder. Here's how I did it. I measured the standard pocket sleeve to include the excess area on the left where the holes go and added a half inch margin on the right that would act as the tab. I set guides on Photoshop so I wouldn't accidentally design on the area that would fall on either side. I then have it printed, punch holes on the left side, divide the height of the divider by the number of sections I have, and cut corresponding tabs on the side. So there you have it. All you need to know about setting up your very own photo card binder. Ready ka na ba to organize your own collection? Share your binders on the K-Munity PH Facebook group or tag us on Twitter at K-Munity PH. Let's talk about your collections with fellow stans and papel slaves. Don't forget to subscribe to K-Munity PH on YouTube for more videos like this and join the Facebook group for exclusive promos, perks, and experiences. Annyeong!